Hello everyone, hi and welcome once again. Hello people of God, you are very much welcome. Some of us are coming in for our very first time. Welcome to this channel. My name is Chantal Ekabe and always I come to you with God's word. We do prophetic prayers also, hallelujah, and we do prophetic words. And this is always according to how the Holy Spirit gives them to me, according to how he lays them on my spirit. And in today's word, I have a prophetic message from our Father in heaven. And this is concerning the month of September and the month of August. Hallelujah, you're very much welcome. And also, please, I want to let you know that we do our prophetic prayers here on this channel. We do what is called prophetic prayers every morning here in the United States, where you can join us irrespective of the place where you find yourself in. If you are in South Africa, wherever you are, all over the world, you can join us. The time is 7 a.m. Denver, Colorado time. Is going to be Mountain Time, that's MST. Please join us every Mondays to Fridays. You are very much welcome as you join us, and I believe it's going to be a blessing to you as you do that, in the mighty name of Jesus. And also, if you want to join this family, you are welcome to do that. Go ahead, subscribe, join us. I believe this family is going to be a blessing to you. God is going to use us to be a blessing to you by his grace. So I just want us to release, be able to, you know, receive this word, rather the word that the Holy Spirit has given to me, especially concerning the month of August and the month of September. But as we always do, please join me. Let's put this word in the hands of God before releasing it by the help of the Holy Spirit. I want us to pray right now and ask God to have his way in the name of Jesus. Dear Lord, we thank you. Father, we worship your name, the God of all grace, God of all things beautiful, the one that has made it possible for us to come back here and be able to share this word, a word in season. Lord, we say thank you. We love you. We acknowledge you. Holy Spirit, we thank you for this inspiration, for this word that is coming from the heart of God. We say have your way in the name of Jesus. And to all those that are coming to listen, those that are coming to feed on this word, Lord, let it be a blessing to them in the name of Jesus. Speak to someone, speak to the heart of someone through this word. Use me today, Lord, as your vessel, as you always do, in Jesus' mighty name. And we cover this word with the blood of Jesus. We decree no weapon formed against it shall prosper in the name of Jesus. Father, we love you and we say thank you for having your way in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen, family. Holy Spirit, I yield myself to your leadership right now in the name of Jesus. Amen. So I want to share with us the word that the Lord gave to me, something that I'm, you know, seeing by the help of the Holy Spirit. So I've been releasing monthly prophetic words. It's not always for every month. It doesn't come for every month, but I do it as the Holy Spirit leads me, as the Lord guides. And last month, I think it was last month or the month of May, I remember the Lord giving me a word concerning the month of July. And he said there was going to be a shift. And by the help of the Holy Spirit, I'm seeing this happening. Because the Lord told me that this shift was also going to come and bring freedom, where people are going to start going back to, you know, fellowship and worship. And it's going to also enhance the move of revival that he has planned. The Lord has been telling me so much about revival these last days, and I've seen this happen by his grace, where things have, you know, gradually opened up, unlike they used to be before. Especially here in the United States, things have opened up a little, things have shifted somehow. And I pray that this continues in the name of Jesus, so that the work of God, the will of God for this end times, for this last days, shall manifest, shall be fulfilled, shall come to pass in the name of Jesus. The Lord says concerning the month of August, I wrote down some things. The Lord said the month of September first, I'm going to start with the month of September. This is going to be a month of fruitfulness. As we all know, the number 9 stands for fruitfulness. So September is a month of fruitfulness. Hallelujah. But then there is August before September. And what came to me from the Lord, and the Lord said, pray for schools. Pray for schools. And when that word came to me, I knew immediately that the Lord was referring to the opening session that is going to begin. I think it's in August or September for some people. There is going to be another session, I think the fall session, that is about to start. The Lord says pray as the people go back to school, pray as students go back to school, as they resume school. The Lord says pray, because I'm seeing like something the enemy is gonna want to do. He's planning it actually, and the target is in schools. The target is going to be schools. It's going to be on children. It's going to be on young children, teenagers also. God has called us to pray about schools. Pray for schools in your personal time. Please pray for schools. Hallelujah. Lift up schools into the hands of the Lord, be it in your country or in any other nation that the Lord has laid it on your heart to pray. Please go ahead and pray about that. I see God doing a lot in the name of Jesus, and whatever the enemy has planned, it will not come to pass in the name of Jesus. And even as your children return back to school, the Lord will protect them, the Lord will preserve them in Jesus' mighty name. This is the second time this word is coming to me concerning schools, and God is asking us to pray for schools. Let His preservation be upon the children. And you know, concerning any virus the enemy is planning to send in there, or demons, whatever it may be, let the will of God stand and let the plan of the enemy fail in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. The Lord says, beware of adversaries. Hallelujah. This is like a warning also. In the month of September, this came to me specifically for the month of September. The Lord says, beware of adversaries. Now, there are going to be some adversaries that will rise up that month. I would say enemies, unfriendly friends, you know, some, you know, things that the enemy is going to want to do through others, through people. People are going to want to rise up to come against what you are doing, what God has called you to do. But in the name of Jesus, it will not stand. We cancel it right now in Jesus' name. This is the essence of a prophetic word. It is not so we take it and we sit down and we just know the Lord has spoken. No, it is when a word comes forward, God wants us to go and pray about this word. Hallelujah. Because God wants to either redeem somebody from something that the enemy is planning. And so we are going to be praying against adversaries. The Lord says, pray also for hospitals. The Lord says, pray for hospitals and those that are in the hospitals in the month of August and the month of September. The Lord says, pray for those that are in the hospital. And if God has called you into a ministry that has to do with the healing of the sick, visiting those that are sick, those that are in the hospital, please, as you go there, pray for them, pray for the sick. Even before stepping your leg into the hospital ground, start prophesying, start declaring words. Hallelujah. Minister the power of God in the name of Jesus. Let the hand of God completely take over, because I see some demonic activities that may want to rise up in the hospitals. Demonic activities. The atmosphere is not going to be very clear. The Lord says, pray. Hallelujah. Pray. Pray, pray. And the Lord says, the Lord reminded me of the harvest and the revival that He is still doing in our lives. The harvest and the revival. He said, harvest and revival. It is still happening. It is still going on. The Lord plans to do so much when it comes to revival here on earth, even before the second coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I had a rapture dream this month, and it's been a long time since I had that dream. I had a rapture dream this month, I think about a week ago. In the rapture dream, Jesus came back and many were taken by surprise. Many were taken by surprise. In that dream, a lot of people wish they could go up with Jesus. I saw people leaving, and a lot of people wish they could go up, because it was as if they will not be able to join those that are going up. And I started seeing in the dream, I saw there was another scene, a scene change, and I saw how people were weeping, you know, people were in sorrow because they were not able to make it with Jesus. But a lot of people did go up to heaven. A lot of people were raptured. Hallelujah. And God is reminding us again of His second coming. His second coming. It is always good for us to live right while waiting for our dear Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to return again for His bride the second time, to come back for His bride. Please, if you haven't given your life to Christ, this is not a joke. These are end times. And don't be taken by surprise. In the dream I had, many were taken by surprise. I pray that is not going to be your portion in the name of Jesus. It is not going to take you unawares. Please confess Jesus this day as your Lord and Savior. And God says that I should tell the people that are going to be listening to me, listening to this word, that they need the help of the Holy Spirit, especially these last days. And he was specific about the month of September, and he said he is going to be releasing that upon many in the name of Jesus. In any area you've been struggling on your own, I see the Holy Spirit coming to help you that month in the name of Jesus. The Lord spoke to me about the help of the Holy Spirit, and he highlighted that part of the word that he gave to me. He said many are going to be needing the help of the Holy Spirit to go through and to also receive divine direction to make it, to overcome, hallelujah, and to receive of every promise that I have spoken to them. He said they will need the help of the Holy Spirit. He said many yet are not having that help. They are not receiving that help. Even though they are believers and Christians, they are still not getting that help. And I pray that God is going to help give us revelation on how to really receive help from the Holy Spirit so we can walk in the way that God has called us to walk and live the life that he has called us to live in the name of Jesus. God says changes are going to hit nations. Hallelujah. Changes are going to hit nations in the name of Jesus. I see the nation of Italy. I see Italy. I know the power of God is going to touch that nation in a powerful way in the name of Jesus. The Lord says, pray for suburb areas. Hallelujah. Those that are in the suburb, those that are in the suburb, in these hidden areas, in these areas, sometimes it can be like an abandoned area. Those that are in the dark, in the hidden, it mustn't be really in the dark, right? But those that are in the suburb, the Lord says, pray for these people. They need my help. They need my touch. And if you can reach out to these people, reach out to these people. Hallelujah. God says, intercede for these people. Whenever you are praying, intercede for these people, for they need the hand of God. They need the touch of God. They need the presence of God. They need to feel God. They need to know that God is with them. Hallelujah. This is the word that God gave to me. The Lord said the Lord will be going on between August and September. He highlighted also the praying for us, for us to pray about schools as they resume. Pray for them. Pray for your children. Pray for the schools they are going to go to. Pray for divine direction in the name of Jesus. I pray the hand of God will continue to preserve many children and teenagers, and they are going to grow up in the fear of the Lord. I pray God will continue to preserve us, preserve our nations, our loved ones and families in the mighty name of Jesus. And above all, I pray the help of the Holy Spirit upon everyone who needs help, who needs help. The Bible says in John chapter 14 verse 16 says, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper. Jesus was the first helper that came from God. Hallelujah. And he's saying that as he's about to leave, he's going to ask the Father to give us another helper. He's also going to be a comforter, an advocate, an intercessor, a counselor, a strengthener. That is who the Holy Spirit is. That is a personality of the Holy Spirit. If you need a comforter, the best comforter you can have is the Holy Spirit, is the person of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Do you need someone to stand as an advocate for you? That is the Holy Spirit. Do you need an intercessor? That is the Holy Spirit. He's the greatest. Hallelujah. One of the greatest intercessors. Jesus is an intercessor when it comes to God and man, but the Holy Spirit is an intercessor when it comes to us serving and meeting the requirements of God and fulfilling our divine purpose here on earth as ordained by our Father. Hallelujah. He says he will be with you forever. He's the Spirit of truth. The Holy Spirit is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive and take to its heart, because it does not see him or know him. But you know him, because he, that is the Holy Spirit, remains with you continually and will always be with you. Let me read this last part before we end. The Holy Spirit will always be with us. I'm praying right now that somebody is going to contact the helper, the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus. Verse 13 of chapter 16 says, the same John, it says, but when he, the Holy Spirit of truth, truth comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will guide you into all truth, full and complete truth. That is what the Amplified Version says. For he will not speak on his own initiative. He will not speak on his own initiative, but he will speak whatever he hears from the Father. That is the message regarding the Son. Hallelujah. And he will disclose to you what is to come. He will disclose to you what is to come. That talks about the future events and all of that, everything God is planning. I pray that someone is going to receive the help of the Holy Spirit starting from now in the name of Jesus. Receive the help of the Holy Spirit. That thing that you could not do on your own, Jesus says the Holy Spirit has come on us this last day so we can be able to achieve them. The places you could not reach, by the hand and mercy of God, receive the help of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. The Lord highlighted this to me. The Holy Spirit is a spirit of truth. He comes to reveal to us the mind of God, the deep things of God, the heart of our Father. Every area where you're asking yourself the will of God, you're doubting what God has for you in that area, I pray that as the Holy Spirit comes on you right now in the name of Jesus, you are receiving the help you need in Jesus' mighty name. May the power of the living God protect you and preserve you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, and this word is sealed with the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you all very much, family. Please go ahead, like the video so that they can keep pushing it for others to see, to listen to this word. If you haven't given your life to Christ, please check my description. There is a prayer for you to become a born again. Hallelujah. Confess Christ and become a born again. And also, I will say, please go ahead and share this word with someone if you can. I believe it's going to be a blessing. God bless you so much. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to subscribe, and I hope to see you in our next word by the special grace of God. Do remain blessed. Bye.